Literally, he cut a promo a couple months ago with a turtle he found on the street. And guess what? At first, you hear me say that and you go, Joe, you're an idiot for watching it.
Uh-huh.
If you started watching it, you would want to finish the whole video. This guy, I think, can elicit anything from anyone. He can get a good promo out of a stick. He can get a good promo out of a follicle of hair. Chris Jericho, to me, even in the ring, he's amazing. But just strictly talking,
yeah.
I think he could be a heel. He could be a
face.
He could be anything he wants to be, and it could be on a flip of a coin. Tonight, if he was on Raw and he wanted to be a heel, guess what? He's going to come on, right? He's going to come on tonight. He's going to be a heel. You're going to hate the guy. Tomorrow, you can go on SmackDown, and he's a face, and you're going to cheer for him, and you're going to love this guy.
Yeah, I would definitely have Jericho in my top 10. My number one is Hot Rod, Rowdy Roddy Piper.
I like that, too.
I mean, a guy who could just go on the mic, and you said, you know, cut a promo with a turtle. Piper, if just look at his Piper Pit segments.
Yep.
He took these jobbers and who couldn't speak a lick of English and just harassed them. He could entice a crowd. I mean, people were trying to kill Roddy Piper. They literally tried to stab him to death because he was just so, you know, could rile up the crowd to hate him. And also, I know he didn't really care to be a good guy, but his good guy run in the early 90s, I love that. And his run in WCW in the mid-90s when he was going up against Hulk Hogan, that is some of my favorite memories of pro wrestling. So, I mean, we could talk a lot about Piper, but we only got 12 minutes, so we got a lot to talk about.
Yeah.
So let's go over our top five. Do you have your top five matches of all time?
I do.
Well, let's just run through them quick. What do
all
you
right.
got? Who all five?
Some of my honorable mentions are a lot of NXT matches.
Okay.
But my five are mostly all old school matches that you would appreciate.
Let's hear them.
My number five is John Cena versus Rob Van Dam from ECW One Night
Stand.
Great
crowd.
The second one, I thought the crowd makes that match, and I think the match itself is not a bad match at all.
Good.
I think it's a great match. Number four is TLC, the original.
SummerSlam 2000.
Those guys innovated wrestling.
Oh,
they
yeah.
changed the game.
For the good or the worse, for the better, you know, good or the bad, you know, they changed it in
yep.
a sense that you have to top this. And it, unfortunately, you know, most
no
of these guys
ever
are.
Top it.
Yeah, I mean, these guys. You know, one of them can't, you know, wrestle again because of his neck. One can't wrestle because of concussion. So it did take the toll, but, you know, that was some great stuff, the TLC matches.
Number three, I have Triple H versus Cactus Jack.
Ah, and your
from
dad
Royal
makes
Rumble.
An appearance.
From, yes, my dad gets crushed into a couple of times by both men. But I think this is a great match.
Oh, it's amazing.
And the physicality of the match is insane. Mick Foley's a lunatic, and I love everything he does in the match. But the story of the match is great, too. How far will Triple H go, and how far is Cactus Jack willing to go to win this match?
Yeah, and there's a lot of callbacks to previous matches. You know, the Royal Rumble from 1999, the previous year, you know, Foley gets handcuffed, and then that happens in this one, and then The Rock comes out and saves him. It's a great match, and it really made Helmsley a credible threat. You know, you always knew he was a good technician, but this showed that he could brawl, you know, with one of the all-time greats. What's your number two?
Number two, I have Hulk Hogan and Andre the Giant.
I mean,
just because, I have to put it on there. And, you know, after hearing the whole story behind this match, you know, from the Andre the Giant documentary, it gave me a newfound appreciation for what actually went down to make that match happen. You know, the world's biggest slam, the slam that changed the industry when Hulkamania ran a wild. Not when it really started. I guess you could say it.
No, it was big for, you know, the previous 4 years, but this is the apex of Hulkamania.
Yeah.
This is the moment. If there was to be a symbol of pro wrestling, you know how they have the logo for the NBA, it's like the silhouette of Jerry West, it would be Hogan slamming Andre. That is the biggest match in wrestling history, for sure.
And then I have to say that I think that the best match of all time is, and you might not like this, is Kenny Omega and Kazuchika Okada. I think you didn't watch this match.
No, I'm sure it's great.
But this match went on for like 45 minutes.
Yeah.
And these guys killed each other. And, you know, the story of Cody Rhodes and the Young Bucks, they want to throw the towel in. Will they throw it?
Okay.
Will they not throw it in? This match went, you know, this happened four times. And even every time they went at it, it was who was going to win. You didn't know really what was going to happen. And every hit was big. Everything. Is he going to tap out? Is he going to give up? Is he not? Who is going to give up? What's going on? Like, it was just pure insanity every time. And I'm not a big indie guy. I like to, you know, read up on him and I'll watch the stories afterwards. But these two guys is one of these two guys' rivalries. Every match they had on was amazing. Their third match was insane. Their fourth one got 7 stars from Meltzer. It was amazing.
All right, so we got to move quickly. My top five matches, I'm not even going to talk about them, but I'm just going to name them. Bret Hart versus the British Bulldog from SummerSlam 92, if you want to see a crazy crowd. I don't know if there's a crazier crowd. Cactus Jack versus Randy Orton from Backlash 2004. Again, it's more of the things that you got from the Royal Rumble match with him versus Triple H, but I think taken to another degree. Thumbtack spots, barbed wire, all that crazy stuff. Kurt Angle versus Chris Benoit from the Royal Rumble 2003. This is just a pure, there's no strikes, really. There's no punches or kicks. This is all grappling, reversal. And suplexes and, just the good stuff that you love. Great knife edge chops between the two. Number two is Hollywood Hulk Hogan versus The Rock from WrestleMania 18. This is the most electric the crowd has ever been in pro wrestling. I love this match. Just go ahead and watch it. We can't really talk about it. And my number one match of all time is Shawn Michaels versus The Undertaker. Not their WrestleMania 25 classic, but their first really big encounter. They had a match before the previous month, but this one, Hell in a Cell from 1997. Crazy bumps, crazy spots, and everything about it is great because it had the introduction of Kane, and that could have went one or two ways. It could have went the way of the Shockmaster with his debut, which is one of the funniest clips ever, but it went another way. It brought a character, Kane, which was building for so long, and it delivered. And Kane's still relevant to this day from just his debut going so well. Everything from the commentary from Vince McMahon, that's gotta be Kane. I love that match, but we gotta move quickly because we only have a few minutes left on the final episode of the Squared Circle. Would you want to go over your dream WrestleMania card? Because that's what I really want to do.
Yeah, let's just do it. All right. So you wrote out everything. I'm going to just shoot from the hip on from the first couple things. I didn't know you did location and everything.
Yeah, I kind of just went crazy.
Yeah, so for your location, you said the Philadelphia Spectrum. I would go with Madison Square Garden.
No, I wouldn't be. Oh, okay. Because I did a different thing. Mine was WCW versus WWE, and that's why I picked the Spectrum, because it was a venue. Philadelphia was both a WCW and a WWE, place. So yeah. I didn't want to be one-sided where Madison Square Garden, no WCW events took place there. So that's why I did there. But if you were to do a WrestleMania, it should be at the Garden, sure. So I don't have a problem with
that. I would say the Garden. Your announcers, you picked Jim Ross, Tony Schiavone.
McMahon, Ventura, and Lawler.
You didn't think I could say that name. It's all right.
Schiavone. Oh, Schiavone, as Chris Jericho used to say.
Oh, nice. I would say I would love to see Vince, Jim Ross, JR, and I would love to see Jerry Lawler. I think I would end it there.
Again, I was going to WCW versus WWE,
yeah,
so I wanted to get Schiavone in there. I wanted to get JR, who was a big WCW announcer. Quickly, who are your matches? What are something that you wrote down?
My big matches, all right. Oh, my God. I wrote this all out pretty badly. I had a tag team match. I had a three-man tag team match between The Shield and The Hart Foundation.
Well, who would be your three members of The Hart Foundation?
I had Brett, Owen, and Jim the Anvil,
okay.
The three of them.
That's
versus
pretty good.
The three members of The Shield. I think that would be a great match to watch.
Definitely.
I actually threw The Miz and Daniel Bryan on my ultimate card. I thought the two of them would be a great stage for them. I had Kurt Angle go against Shawn Michaels.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's been done before at a Mania, and it's one of the best matches ever.
And that's why I put it on there. You can't go wrong. I had Dwayne The Rock Johnson and Samoa Joe.
Ah.
I feel like that would tell a great story between the two of them, who's the ultimate Samoan or something like that. I think that would be great.
A Samoan on a stick match.
I did a TLC match with all our original members of TLC,
uh-huh,
with the Undisputed Era from NXT.
Man.
It could be any member of the Undisputed Era.
Okay.
But it's got to have at least Kyle O'Reilly. I thought it would be great. I had in a women's match, I had AJ Lee, Natalya, Lita, and Ronda Rousey.
A Braun Panties match.
Yeah, sure.
Oh, yeah.
I have Chris Jericho and Triple H in a match. I had Taker and Kane in a match. And that's really, I guess, all the crazy.
All right, I had
an ECW match, too, where I had, the Sandman and Sabu.
That's not bad.
Like, a bunch of crazy stuff.
I should have had more ECW involvement, but mine was mostly WCW versus WWF, or WWE as it is known today. So I had Hulk Hogan from 1987, his apex year, versus the Nature Boy, woo, Ric Flair, from that same year. And this is a unification match for both heavyweight championships, and I got Hulk Hogan winning because he was the babyface. I got Stone Cold Steve Austin from 1998 when he was red hot versus the guy on the other company that was just as red hot, Goldberg, and I got Stone Cold Steve Austin winning that one. I got a battle of the People Champs, the People's Champs, rather, The Rock from 2000 versus Diamond Dallas Page. Bang! I got Page winning that
one. Oh, it's awful booking.
No, because you can't have all WWF guys winning. I have The Undertaker from 97 taking on Sting from 97. I got Undertaker winning that one. I got a WCW and WWF tag team unification match. The Steiner Brothers from 1991 versus the British Bulldogs from 1986. Got the Steiners winning that one. This is kind of a rematch from WrestleMania. Ricky Steamboat from 1989 versus the Macho Man Randy Savage. Aha, dig it! From 1987. This is a Intercontinental and U.S. title unification match. I got Steamboat winning this one.
I like that.
Listen to this match. A Texas bull rope match between Dusty Rhodes with the American Dream taking on his son, Goldust, for ruining the family name. I got Dusty winning that one. I got a Piper's Pit segment with
Eric Bischoff. I would have Goldust win that match.
Either way it could go. I got Eddie Guerrero from 1997 versus Owen Hart from 1994 versus Rey Mysterio from 1996. I got Owen Hart winning that one.
I like that.
Shawn Michaels from 96 versus Chris Benoit from 1998 in a ladder match for the number one contendership. I got HBK winning that. I got the New Age Outlaws from 98 versus the Outsiders from 96. I got the Outsiders winning. This one, a sleeper match. Bret the Hitman Hart from 1994 versus Arn Anderson from 1987 in a submission match. And I'd start off the show with a bang with Mr. Perfect Kurt Hennig from 1991 taking on the five-time WCW champion Booker T from 1998. Booker I got T. Booker T winning that one.
Damn.
And I didn't pick a winner of the Brett versus Arn match. I'd have to go with Brett, though.
I mean, I don't see how Brett couldn't win that
match. That is the greatest card ever assembled. And this is the greatest pro wrestling show on a college radio station in Nassau County ever. Would you agree?
100%.
Everyone agrees. So this is going to wrap things up. For Joe Ritter, for Anthony Tartamello, who started this with me, for Dominic Arbolino, who joined, you know, somewhat through, and even Gabe, who was there for just a cup of coffee. Yeah. Cup of coffee in the big leagues. Yeah. Any parting words, Joe, for the fine
Thank you,
people?
Everyone, for listening and enjoying.
Yes. We appreciate it.
That one guy who called the one time and we couldn't understand what he said.
Oh, yes. We've had a few weird
John
callers.
From Freeport.
John from Freeport listens. All right,
Brandon Johnson and his mom.
Brandon Johnson and his mom. Sounds like a
Mrs.
good band
Mrs. Johnson,
name.
Thank you so much. I know she listens.
Oh, yeah.
She does listen. So thank you for listening.
Them. Well, thanks for everyone for listening over the year or so. And, you know, if you want to hear more pro wrestling, like I said, I talk the old stuff on my Saturday show. Joe. It's been a pleasure.
It was.
Have a good
one, guys. Dominic Arbolino also. Thank you for doing the show for a while.
Thank you. Have a good one, guys.